contingency table and chi-square test using SPSS. Contingency table, the other name is cross-tabulation or two-way table, is a frequency distribution table in a matrix format that shows the relationship between two categorical variables simultaneously. A significance test between the relationship of two categorical variables is performed by chi-square test. Let's see an example. So this is SPSS data file, and you see we have two variables, gender and occupation. So we want to see whether there are actually a relationship between the gender and occupation. And to do that, we need to go to the analyze, and then we have to go to the descriptive statistics. And under the descriptive statistics, you see there's option of cross tab. You have to click on cross tab. So if I click the cross tab, here is option of row, here is option of column. So you can put one variable in row and another one is the column. So if I put the gender under the row option and occupation under the column option, and if you want to test the significance of the relationship, just go to the statistics, and under the statistics there is a chi-square option. So click that chi-square option, press continue. And if you also want to show the result through bar chart, you can also do that. So you can click just this one, display clustered bar chart, and press OK. Now you will get the result here. So this is the table that actually shows the cross-tabulation between the gender and the occupation. So from this table, you can see we have total 400 observation, and from this 400 sample, you can see that between the male and female, between these two groups, most of the respondent are male. Okay. Now, I can interpret this table row-wise, or it can be explained by the column-wise. So if I want to explain this in terms of the column wise, so you can say that among the respondents who actually does private occupation or private job, so you see that private job total 130 respondent actually does private job. So among these, most of them are actually male. You see 92, so 92 male, they are actually respondent doing private job compared to the female, which is 38. Similarly, if you can explain, if you want to explain according to the row wise, you see that among the female gender respondent, most of them are actually doing the private job. So you see this is the row, so total 93 female respondent, and among these 93, most of them actually doing private, because this 38 is the highest. However, if you say that if you want to see in terms of the male respondent, so you can see that there are total 307 male respondent, and among them most of them actually doing what? Business, because 104 is the highest, right? And in terms of the also occupation, you see, so this is the total respondents of this total respondent. From this total respondent, most of them actually doing private job. This is 130 is the highest, right? And the second one is the 127. And you can simply explain this in terms of percentage. So if you want to see what percentage of respondent actually doing the private job, or among the male respondent, what percentage of them actually doing the private job, you simply divide private job by the total number of male respondents, so you can get the percentage figure. Now the second thing is that you can also show this result in terms of the image or bar chart. So you can see this is the bar chart. So by looking at at this bar chart, you can simply say, just like this is the male respondent, and you see this the highest bar is in terms of this color. So if you see, this is the business. So we have already find the same thing from our table. So most of the male among 307 male respondent, most of them actually doing the business. So this is the most highest peak, right? So you can also explain this through this bar chart. Now the question is that whether this relationship between these two categorical variables, that is gender and occupation, is statistically significant. You can explain that through this chi-square test result. So you see the Pearson chi-square. So you just need to see the significance level of this one. So if we look at this, it is 0.001, which is actually less than 1%, right? So this means that there is significant relationship between these two categorical variables.